Everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Big John, aka the amazing fasting fat man, aka the incredible shrinking man. And today I continue my adventure of my carnivore OMAD diet. Now, there's a couple of people that I told you last week we did interviews, and the link will be in the description box. It's I did a podcast with Mind Body Breakthrough. And I did an interview with Conscious Calisthenics, and both those links will be in the description box. And there's another interview that I did that I think you guys will just enjoy. And here's a little preview.
There's companies putting things in our food that make us addicted to
food. Absolutely. You know, I've always had that problem with weight. I just loved food.
It's like cocaine.
I do believe that I've broken my addiction. Food was prevalent. It's in the back of my mind. Ooh, what time is it? When am I going to eat?
Part of the reason why I think no one's really talking about this is there's no money in it.
Not only is there no money in it, it costs people money. When my wife told me she was pregnant, I told her I'm going to lose the weight because I don't want a son to see me fat. So once I learned that, I'm like, you know what? I could do this.
100 million Americans have diabetes, and most of them are African Americans. I just want to get this information out there so we can stop dying.
I hope to lose the weight, but I also hope to inspire others to do it. How is that? Was that not fantastic? Look, I did the interview, and when I seen that promo, I was like, wow, I can't wait to see this. Fantastic job. Anyway, normally I weigh myself at the beginning of the thing. As you guys know, last week my scale was broken, so I ordered a new one. Well, here go what happens with the new one.
Okay, folks, what you are looking at right now is the scale I ordered. It's supposed to be a glass top scale. It just came, I unpack it and pull it out the box, and look at this. All the glass is broken. It's just a broken mess. It's ridiculous. I did not expect this. In a way, I think it's serendipitous, because I could imagine, like, whatever glass is made of is not sturdy, and it might have broke anyway with me just stepping on it, even at my light frame. I guess the old scale is still extracting revenge from beyond the grave. I have to order another one. Next time I'm not going to try to get so fancy. This was some scale. It was like a glass top, and then it had the stand where, like, the digital reading was on top. It wasn't on the floor. It was like a pole attached to it, and I thought that would have been so much better. But I'm going to look for another scale, something that's all metal so it doesn't break during transportation, and I am going to get my money back for this one. But hopefully I could order one and it gets here on time. You know what? Actually, I'm just going to get something from Amazon. Let me see what they have in weight scale. Since I'm no longer over 400 pounds, I don't need scales that go up that high. And I have no intentions of going back, so. The scale is getting revenge from beyond the grave. I'm telling you. All right, guys.
I think the spirit of the old scale is haunting this place. I mean, the other day I had a nightmare where I stepped on a scale and I was like 450 pounds. It's taunting me. I'm not even joking. I really had that dream. Like, it's crazy. But I was gonna order another scale from Amazon so it could get here before I did my broadcast. But when I called those people to give them a piece of my mind, they were so nice on the phone. They promised, look, we're going to rush you another scale. We are so sorry. This doesn't really happen. And the only reason, well, one, I was trying to get my money back, and they offered to give me another scale. I don't think they wanted to go down that route. But the only reason I was fine with it is because my wife told me something which made sense. She said that, now we have a gate, a front gate that's pretty tall. It's like taller than me. And we normally lock it at night. And the morning the scale arrived, the box was just like over the gate. Like someone took it and tossed it over the gate. So she said that she thinks whoever it is that delivered the scale When they threw it over the gate, it broke. Now, the scale wasn't packed in, you know, the packing bubbles or anything like that. It was just, you know, regular packing. They stuffed, like, those papers in it. So it's quite possible that it's not their fault. So I'm going to get the scale. I'm going to try it out. And I'm going to see. Because since I'm not getting my money back, it makes no sense to get another scale. Let me try the scale out and, you know, and hopefully I'm small enough that it doesn't break. Now, this scale is supposed to go up to 400 pounds. So I think I should be able to weigh myself without the glass actually breaking. But anyway, I have another special video for you. Take it away. Hello, everyone. It's the Walking Fat Man. A lot of you guys ask if I, you know, still walk. And some of you ask, do I exercise? You know, I still walk. I walk daily, weather permitted and job permitting. Because, you know, I do work from home and sometimes I'm behind eight ball. So I'm unable to walk. But I'm always walking with my little buddy here. That's my business partner. My walking partner, my inspiration, you know? But pretty much, yeah, I walk every day. I try to get in about an hour and a half each day. And, you know, when I was doing the long-term fast, I used to walk and then come back home and do a Biggest Loser DVD. But now that I'm able to go to the gym, I pretty much will do some walking, and then when the wife gets home, I'll walk over to the gym, which is about, I would say, about a mile and a quarter away from my home. So I walk to the gym and I'll get my workout in, and then I walk back home. So that's an additional, I guess, about 2 miles, 2.5 miles of walking. And that's pretty much it. I thought I'd start including other segments, because I'm sure you guys must be bored of seeing me inside the house every single broadcast. I mean, with the exception of the one time I was in Atlantic City. So that's pretty much it. Back to you, Mr. Fat Man. That is my daily workout routine. Well, my daily walking routine with my little partner that I get done every day. Pretty much, I try to get as much walking as possible. Even if I don't have the time to go to the gym, I try to get a little something done in my home gym. Now, I'm thinking about switching it up a bit and going less, because I was really lifting heavy. But I think what I'm going to start doing is going very light, so I could just kind of like burn out and do a more cardio type routine when it comes to lifting. And then when I reach my goal weight, I'll try to bulk up anyway. Because when I reach my goal weight, I plan on training for a year to enter a bodybuilding competition. That's going to be the next twist in the Fasting Fat Man saga. Although by then I'll probably be the Fasting Fit Man. Also, a lot of you guys ask about whether I would fast again. Look, I have that arrow in my quiver. After all, I am the Fasting Fat Man. If need be, if I get to October and I see, like, look, the only way I'm going to reach my goal is to burn it out with another fast, I have no problem with fasting, you know, October, November, going into December to get to my goal weight. Now, my whole thing is, I'm just happy that I've changed the relationship with my food, because, you know, I ended my fast back on May 31st. And again, I haven't been hungry. I haven't been tempted to cheat. There is no cheating with me. It's just like food now. I'm really following Benjamin Franklin's quote. One should eat to live, not live to eat. And the previous me, I used to live to eat. That's all I did. Now, you know, I'm just eating to survive. Like, to me, it's like I could take it or leave it. I'm fine. Although I do cook some very tasty meals, as you will see right now with the Fat Man in the Kitchen.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Fat Man's Kitchen. For today's carnivore delight, we have some sauteed liver, fried pork shoulder cut in chunks, and as you can see, boiled eggs cut in half. Now, from what I understand of the carnivore, you're supposed to get organ meat as a part of your repertoire. Now, fortunately enough, I love liver, and that's basically because of my mother's extraordinary culinary skills. When I was younger, she used to make sauteed liver and onions that was absolutely to die for. So I grew up loving liver. And the funny thing is, when I was in high school, I went over to a friend's house for dinner and his mother cooked liver. And if I had to eat liver like that, then I would definitely be one of those people who hated liver. The liver was dry, it was bland, but you know, fortunately, fate rolled the dice and I ended up loving liver. So I have liver, pork, and eggs. And over here, you have bubbly sparkling water, nice cold can. That's what I'm gonna have. All I've been having on the carnivore since since a few, you know, like I did have the shake that one time to balance things out. I haven't had the shake since. I've just been having meat and water. I do have eggs, like scrambled eggs and things like that, or bacon and eggs. But pretty much it's meat, water. And the water I have is sometimes sparkling mineral water. It's all water except for tap water. It's just like the fast. I drank all water except for tap water because, as you know, tap water is kind of rolling the dice on your health nowadays. So anyway, that's it for my carnivore OMAD meal for today. Back to you, Mr. Fat Man.
I have to tell you, that was delicious. I mean, I know I always say it's delicious. Unless I invite you guys over to the house, you just don't understand. Like, I could really cook. Well, obviously, I could cook. I mean, you know, I got this way from cooking. That's the one good thing. Well, that's a lot of good things. I can't say the one good thing. My mother taught me to cook, and I've carried that to excess, of course. But now, you know, I'm throwing down some very wonderful combinations. Oh, the other thing. Listen, I am not a doctor. Although I would love to play one on TV. But I have to say, you know, a lot of people, you know, telling me that eating all meat is bad, it's a mistake. Listen, I can only go by what I research. And even, you know, to more of a degree, common sense. There are Eskimos in Siberia, you know, in Antarctica, that literally can't eat a plant-based diet. They literally have, in order to survive, they have to eat meat and fat from the animals. And they're perfectly fine. So I honestly don't think that me going carnivore in the interim to see how much weight I could lose, and even if it kicks in, whereas I stay carnivore until I get to my goal weight in December, I honestly don't think that's going to have an adverse reaction. Now, you know, some will say, well, it's hard to have bowel movements if you eat all meat. But from what I've seen of the people doing carnivore on YouTube, that's not an issue. But you know me, look, I just had an epic battle with a terrorist turd. So at the first sign of constipation, I would ditch it. But so far, so good. I haven't had a problem. You know, I started a carnivore last week Monday, and I haven't had a problem. So I've been regular and it's been fine. I get all my fat contents. I'm good. So far, so good, I should say. You know, I mean, yeah, I don't know what's going to happen between now and when I get to my goal weight, but so far, so good. I have absolutely no problem with it. And that's pretty much it, folks. You know, I'm going to stay with the carnivore OMAD. And if need be, if I need to fast again to get to my goal weight, I'll fast again to get to my goal weight. But I think if I slow down on the bulk lifting and concentrate more on cardio, I think that should be enough to get me to my goal. And if not, like I said, I have that arrow in my quiver, I'll shoot it if need be. But anyway, that's it for this week. Next week, I will definitely have a scale one way or the other. The scale arrived. I'll check it out, set it up. You know, hopefully it doesn't come in pieces again. But I thought it was going to come today because they swore to me they was going to rush deliver it. And I got the scale 2 days ago. 2 days ago, the broken scale came 2 days ago. And rush delivery to me would mean that I'm getting it around now, at least today. But maybe it'll come tomorrow. I don't know. I didn't want to hold off the broadcast another day because tomorrow's Friday. I'm going to be extremely busy. And the weekends are bad too. So anyway, guys, take care. Please like, share, subscribe. I will see you guys next week. Keep the questions coming. Any suggestions you have, please let me know. Take care. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.